North American media outlets. We're going to go to Bill Pritchard from WrestleZone. Hi, Bill.
Hello, how are you all?
Good, how are you?
Hi.
Good. So, Cassie and Jess, you... There was rumors that, or speculation that you might show up at Slammiversary, and obviously you've been open about your visa issues. I was wondering if you can maybe talk about how that all worked out and maybe how long you knew that Bound for Glory was definitely going to work out, where, you know, you could talk about, you know, announcing the appearance and all that.
Yeah, so when the rumors were kind of going around about Slammiversary, our visa issues were not even nearly fixed. We actually had our agent come in and save the day. He was a knight in shining armor, and he took on the responsibility of taking over our visa so that we could work in this country and continue to wrestle like we want to do. And so Bound for Glory, Jess, how long?
Yes, that's got an awful memory. I want to say it was cutting it close, I'll be honest. It was weeks, and then everything was finalized. So we were hoping it was Bound for Glory, and we were praying, and I'm so glad that that worked out. But there was a couple of times where I was like struggling to figure out a timeline. But thank goodness it's all done and sorted. Like I said, our agent came in and just absolutely saved us. And now we're going to be at Bound for Glory, Big Show of the Year. You know, sold out arena, tag team championship match. You know, it's all coming together, coming up roses.
It worked out perfectly. It really did.
Thank you all. Well, forward to the show.
Thank you.
So next we've got Miranda from Big Gold Belt Media. Hi, Miranda.
Hello. Hi, Jesse. Hi, Cassie. Hi, Gail.
Hi.
So, Cassie and Jesse, your promos and interviews have been really popular. Fans gravitate towards your personalities and not only what you do in the ring, but your backstage interviews and really how you communicate together, but with fans. The key word of the day is inspired. So I wanted to ask, what inspires your promos and really some of your comedic, you know, communications and promos?
So what you see from us, any kind of on Twitter or on TV, anything you see, literally that is us when we're just together in the car, at each other's house, on an off day. That's literally how we communicate with each other. Jess will do anything to make me laugh, and that's kind of like her goal, is to like crack me, which I love. I just think, you know, our history together, how long we've been best friends and our chemistry, it's so easy for us to be able to just be ourselves and connect with our audience. Everyone's got a best friend. Everyone grew up with someone, and you just kind of have this like secret language between each other. And that's what we are. And it just connects because, like I said, everyone's got that person in their lives.
Yeah. And I think that people can tell if something's genuine or not. So I think the reason why, you know, our promos and interactions translate so well is because it is so genuine. We literally spend every day together or talking. Last week we spent a 12-hour shoot slash day together. And then on the way home, we were talking in the car. I was like, we just spent 12 hours and we just started laughing. It's just, there's nothing that we don't talk about. She knows everything about me. I know everything about her. It's just that unbreakable bond. So I think that's what kind of draws people in. And I hope that they have someone like that in their lives because it's amazing. But I think that's definitely where we kind of draw that inspiration from. It's just our everyday lives. We just want to make it as real and as authentic as possible.
Thank you, and best of luck this weekend.
Thank you.
That's just beautiful. I love the sisterhood.
Yes.
It's just a natural thing in wrestling too, right? But when you guys have known each other before wrestling, that's the bond is even stronger. So now we have Miranda. After Miranda. Joey from the Angle Podcast. I make mistakes, guys. Joey?
Joey. No problem. Yeah, how are you guys?
Hi, Joey.
Today? So my question is based upon tag team wrestling, which we know is a vital part of pro wrestling, and we've never really seen a team with such great chemistry like the Inspiration. Now, did your decision at the beginning to become a team all around the world lean more from your friendship being so strong, or from in general have a special love for tag team wrestling?
I'd say a bit of both, to be honest. I mean, obviously our friendship was the driving force behind it, but when we started exploring tag team wrestling and being like, oh my gosh, we could do moves together, this would be so much fun. So when we started exploring that aspect, that's when the love of tag team wrestling really became real for us. And then, you know, we've been a tag team for so long now. I'm just so grateful to be able to have a tag team partner in the ring and then in real life. But it was definitely the perfect balance of each.
Awesome. Definitely. Awesome. And on a personal note, I'm so happy to see you both together in the same company, and really in a company that prides themselves on their women's division, because you both are mega stars and deserve really everything that this business has to offer. So good luck at Bound for Glory.
Oh, thank you so much.
Thank you, big cutie, you.
Thank you. Have a good one.
Thanks, Joey. Okay, up next we have Kristen from Bell to Bells.
Hey, ladies.
Hi.
Hi. Yeah, so you know, you talked about you've known each other for so long and you work together so seamlessly, both in and out of the ring, through your podcast. We're happy you stay together, but was that always the idea to remain a tag team, or will you be going after singles competition while you're at Impact?
Our focus is completely on being in the tag team division. We want to be Impact Women's champions, tag team champions. So that's where all our focus is going, and that's where all our focus has been these past few months. So, I mean, we're going to support each other no matter what. We're always going to be in each other's corner, but the tag titles, that's where our head is at, and we have so much to focus on this Saturday at Bound for Glory against Decay, because that is going to be one of the biggest matches of our careers. We've got a challenge ahead of us.
Yes.
And they have about as long of a career as you both do. I mean, it's got to be pretty intimidating. What's your strategy going in?
It's, you know, we've been studying them, obviously. You have to know who you're getting in the ring with. We're good at that. I will say, Decay, you know, you look at them and you think, oof, they're physically dominating. And they work well together as a team, which is something that we can respect. They have good chemistry as well, but we're going to do whatever it takes to become the tag champions. And I know that they're going to fight for it as well. So it's a tall order, but we have a lot to prove. So we're up for the challenge and we're just going to give it our damn all and inspire Impact along the way.
Well, we look forward to seeing you Saturday and good luck.
Thank you so much.
Next up, we have TNA Impact Wrestling historian, who I've spoken to before, Michael. How are you, Michael?
Hey, Gail. Boy, you make me sound Michael way more important than I am.
Yeah, everyone, Michael knows everything, way more than I know about TNA Impact, okay?
That's amazing.
Knows the ins and all the secrets.
Yes. No, thank you for having me. You know, welcome to Impact. Very excited for both of you. And I wanted to ask you about a topic that is, you know, sometimes like a hot topic, and other times it just kind of disappears for a while. What are your thoughts on the pros and cons of intergender wrestling? And should there be more or less of it? I know some people, I actually discussed this with Gail previously, and some people have really strong opinions on it, others don't. I'm just curious about from both of you, you know, what are your thoughts and where do you think it should go?
I think everything has its place in wrestling. The industry has a spot for everyone, and if that's your piece of cake, then you should eat your piece of cake. Jess and I both came up training with men, and I feel like we learned so much that way. So, I mean, I love getting in the ring with the guys. When we go to flatbacks and we go to training, we're always having matches against Spears and Breezy. So it's like, I feel like there's a place for everything. Is that something I'm looking to do? No, because Jess and I are a team and we're going to stick to that. And that's where our focus is. But if that's what you like, then knock your socks off.
Absolutely. If that's what you want to do, go for it, mate.
Exactly.